Welcome to our channel. Today, we're diving into the fascinating world of construction to explore the various types of excavations. Excavation is the unsung hero of construction. Without a solid excavation, you can't build a house, a skyscraper, or even a simple sidewalk. Over the next few minutes, we're gonna get our hands dirty, metaphorically speaking, and explore the different types of excavations. We'll talk about the tools, the techniques, and the challenges that come with moving tons of earth. So buckle up, grab your hard hat, and let's dig in. Before we get into the nitty-gritty, let's talk about why excavation matters. Imagine building a house on sand. Not gonna end well, right? Excavation is all about preparing the site, ensuring the ground is stable and safe for whatever we're building on top of it. It's the essential first step that sets the stage for everything that follows. Without a proper excavation, you're risking cracks, collapses, and a whole heap of trouble down the road. Whether it's a skyscraper or a septic tank, a solid foundation starts with a well-executed excavation. And let me tell you, it's not just about digging holes. It's about understanding the soil, working with different types of equipment, and making sure everything is level, graded, and secure. It's a dangerous job, no doubt. But in the hands of skilled operators and laborers, it's an art form. So the next time you see a construction site, take a moment to appreciate the guys and gals down in the trenches. All right, let's talk trenches. Trench excavation is all about digging those long, narrow ditches in the ground. Think pipelines, utilities, drainage systems, anything that needs to run underground, you're gonna need a trench. Now, these trenches can be shallow or deep, depending on the project. Safety is paramount here, folks. The deeper you go, the greater the risk of a cave-in. That's why shoring and bracing are so crucial. These systems act like temporary walls, preventing the trench from collapsing and putting workers at risk. Trench excavation is a job for skilled operators. You gotta be precise with your cuts, making sure the trench is the right width and depth. It's a delicate dance between man and machine, and it takes a keen eye and a steady hand to get it right. All right, let's talk basements. Now, basements are like the hidden gems of a house, but before you can enjoy that extra square footage, you gotta dig. This type of excavation is all about digging a big rectangular hole that will eventually become the foundation for your basement. Now, basement excavation can be a bit trickier than other types of excavation because you're dealing with a much larger area. You gotta worry about things like soil stability, water drainage, and making sure the whole thing doesn't cave in on itself. That's why it's crucial to have a solid plan and experienced excavators on the job. They'll use a combination of heavy equipment, like excavators and bulldozers, to move the earth and shape the excavation to the right dimensions. You also gotta think about things like utility lines and sewer connections. Basement excavation is a big job, but it's an essential one if you want that extra space below ground. Chapter 4, Deep Dive Dredging. Hold your breath and grab your scuba gear, because we're diving into the underwater world of dredging. We're talking about rivers, harbors, canals, even lakes, any body of water that needs a little TLC. See, over time, sediment, debris, and all sorts of muck can accumulate on the bottom, making it shallow and difficult for boats to navigate. That's where dredging comes in. It's like underwater vacuuming on a massive scale. We're talking about giant, powerful machines that suck up sediment and muck from the bottom of the water body. Dredging can stir up sediment and release nutrients back into the water, which can affect water quality. Dredging keeps our waterways navigable, our ports operational, and our beaches beautiful. Chapter 5, Mucking About Muck Excavation. Get ready to get dirty, folks, because we're talking about muck excavation. Muck is that messy, goopy mixture of soil, water, and organic matter that's about as fun to work with as it sounds. It's sticky, it's heavy, and it can really bog down your equipment if you're not careful. Muck excavation requires specialized equipment and techniques to handle that sloppy, unpredictable material. One common method is using a hydraulic excavator with a special muck bucket. These buckets have holes or slots that allow water to drain out, making the muck easier to handle. Another method is using a dredging pump to suck up the muck and transport it to a disposal area. Muck excavation is essential for a variety of projects, from building foundations in wet areas to creating ponds and waterways. It's a messy, challenging job that requires skill, patience, and a good pair of waterproof boots. Chapter 6, Moving Mountains Earth Excavation. We're going old school, folks, back to the basics with earth excavation. This is the bread and butter of excavation work, the kind of digging that's been going on for centuries. We're talking about moving large quantities of earth, whether it's for a building foundation, a roadbed, or a landscaping project. You've got to consider the type of soil you're dealing with, the slope of the land, and the accessibility of the site. And then there's the equipment. We're talking bulldozers, excavators, loaders, scrapers, the heavy hitters of the construction world. Skilled operators are crucial for efficient and safe earth excavation. Whether it's clearing a site for a new development or shaping the landscape for a park, earth excavation is the foundation for countless projects that shape our world. Chapter 7. Breaking it down, rock excavation. Hold on tight, folks, because things are about to get explosive. We're talking rock excavation, the heavy metal cousin of earth moving. When you gotta move mountains, but the mountains don't wanna move, that's when you call in the rock busters. Forget shovels and backhoes. We're talking about drills, blasting caps, and enough dynamite to make a Hollywood stunt coordinator proud. Rock excavation is all about breaking up solid rock into manageable chunks so it can be hauled away. You got your drilling and blasting, which is exactly what it sounds like. Drilling holes into the rock and then, well, blasting it apart. Then there's mechanical excavation, which uses specialized equipment like hydraulic hammers and rock breakers to chip away at the rock. Rock excavation is dangerous work, no doubt, but it's also incredibly impressive to watch. Chapter 8. Skin deep, topsoil excavation. Let's talk topsoil. Now, topsoil might not be as glamorous as rock blasting or as heavy duty as muck excavation, but it's the lifeblood of any landscape. Topsoil excavation is all about carefully removing and preserving that precious topsoil so it can be reused later. Think of it like peeling back the skin of the earth, preserving it, and then putting it back in place once the construction is done. Skilled operators use specialized equipment like scrapers and graders to carefully peel back the topsoil and stockpile it for later use. Topsoil can be easily compacted or eroded if it's not handled properly. That's why it's often stockpiled in large mounds, covered with tarps, and protected from the elements. Topsoil excavation might seem like a small detail in the grand scheme of a construction project, but it's a crucial step in ensuring the long-term health and beauty of the landscape. Chapter 9. Setting the foundation footing excavation. Alright, let's talk foundations. Specifically, footing excavation, the unsung hero of structural stability. See, before you can even think about pouring concrete for your foundation walls, you gotta dig those trenches for the footings. Footings are like the wide feet of your foundation, transferring the weight of the entire structure down to the ground below. Footing excavation is all about precision and accuracy. The trenches have to be the right depth, width, and slope to ensure the footings are properly supported. Skilled operators use a variety of equipment, from compact excavators to laser-guided trenches, to create those perfect trenches. So, the next time you marvel at a towering skyscraper or a sprawling bridge, remember the humble footing excavation that makes it all possible. It's the unseen foundation that keeps our built world standing strong. Chapter 10. Paving the way, roadway excavation. Fasten your seatbelts, folks, because we're hitting the road with roadway excavation. From highways to driveways, roads connect us all, and it all starts with a well-executed excavation. Roadway excavation is all about moving massive amounts of earth to create a smooth, stable base for the road surface. This type of excavation requires a symphony of heavy equipment working in perfect harmony. You got your bulldozers clearing the way, excavators digging trenches for drainage, and graders shaping the roadbed to the precise specifications. Roadway excavation often involves installing layers of different materials, like gravel, sand, and geotextiles, to create a stable foundation that can withstand the elements and the constant pounding of traffic. But the next time you're cruising down the highway, take a moment to appreciate the incredible feat of engineering that made it all possible. That's a wrap. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more construction insights. We've covered a lot of ground today, from digging trenches to moving mountains, but the main takeaway here is this. Excavation is the essential foundation for our built environment. It's the dirty, dangerous, and often overlooked work that makes everything else possible. So next time you see a construction site, take a moment to appreciate the skilled men and women who are literally shaping the world around us, one cubic yard at a time.